Hello, a very good morning. So news from Frontier IP Group this morning reporting interim profits, which are ahead of management expectations and have continued to make progress in the second half of the year. So we'll go through some of those details now with Neil Crabb. Good to see you. So £10.3 million pre-tax profit for the half year to the 31st of December. This is an increase of 239% on a year earlier. So Neil, good to see you this Friday morning. So what would you say these numbers, this performance, what would you say it reflects?
Well, the primary immediate driver was that we had a big success with Exscientia going public on the NASDAQ, and obviously that made a significant contribution. But actually the portfolio coming behind that is also performing extremely well. So we're very pleased to see that. And obviously the interim numbers, as you say, up 239%, but also equivalent roughly to the pre-tax profit of the entirety of last year. So there's clearly very strong growth coming through. I think for us as well, as important as the event of the IPO with Exscientia was that we subsequently, post the year end, post the half year end, realized the sale of a quarter of our holding. And what that's done is to give us a strong financial position. So, results driven by really good delivery within the portfolio, but importantly, converting that to a stronger balance sheet position from a cash perspective, which in the uncertain environment that we currently find ourselves, I think is particularly important.
Okay, let's maybe pick up on that then, because you've mentioned the environment. Of course, it's rather tumultuous at the moment for a variety of reasons, lots of macroeconomics that will put hurdles in the way of companies such as yourselves. So how have you been mitigating all of that?
Yeah, so the first most obvious thing is just to make sure that you're well financed. And clearly, as I say, we've done that. The next thing is to review with the portfolio companies. We've been going through the process of looking at everywhere where we see exposure. This in many ways mirrors actually what happened when the COVID pandemic came out. Something new emerges and you need to just work through the process of saying, well, where are we seeing impacts that we weren't expecting? And we've taken those disciplines and we're doing the same thing really with what's happening as a result of the Ukrainian trigger, but actually the setting up other things, inflation and things were already moving before that obviously broke out. So I think we've got a pretty good handle on that. The other thing to say as well is that while there are clearly challenges, it is worth remembering, as indeed happened with COVID, that there are opportunities that arise as well as challenges. So, for example, the semiconductor industry, we all know there are supply chain challenges, there are dependencies that are specifically Ukraine related. And on the other hand, there's a greater focus on more efficient parts. Can you reduce the number of components? And those are things that we have in the portfolio. I think increasingly as well, there's a big theme that we'll see as economic conditions become more challenging, people will worry more about cost reduction and payback times in what they do. And again, most of our portfolio is oriented that way because we've always thought that way. So I think there will be difficulties that you need to think about how you manage. I think fundraisings may take a bit longer as well because investors are uncertain. Mm-hmm. And on the other hand, definitely this will emphasize some of the strengths for the portfolio. We're seeing energy prices rising. Well, if you've got things that are more energy efficient, their absolute costs might go up, but their relative advantage to the existing way of doing things is also increased because they're using less energy overall. So I think you've got to have a realistic attitude about the challenges, but it's worth recognizing that there will be opportunities as well that come with that.
All right. Well, come back and tell us all about those opportunities as they arise for you there, Neil. Thank you very much indeed from Frontier IP Group here on Proactive London this morning.